Hello everyone, and welcome to the new summer semester of Friedrich Alexander Universitat. As you can see, I'm not Mark Steiminger, nor am I Christian Rees. I am Rana Kosti, and I will be the one who will take most of the lectures for computer vision course this semester, and I will be the main point of contact for you also for the lectures. As you already know, along with a lot of changes the university is going through, because we are shifting our teaching format to online, most of the courses have started recording the lectures, publishing the lectures, and so on and so forth. And this is the first video recording of computer vision lecture. So yay! We are going to go through the whole semester no matter what. In the worst case scenario, it will all be online. I hope it is not, because I would really want to sit along with you in the classroom face to face and talk with you directly. But in any case, we have some changes for that specifically. We have some provisions for that so that you can talk with me directly if you want. We will come to that later. I want to say something about the coronavirus situation. It is very unfortunate, and I'm sorry to know if someone is suffering from it, and I hope that you get well soon. The German government is helping the universities and its citizens quite well, and we keep our social distancing measures, and we follow the rules, and that's all we need to do for taking care of ourselves. Anyways, so there is a new format for teaching the computer vision course, and I'm going to go through the first lecture, the first part of this first lecture, and I will try to explain to you who is in the team, who are the lecturers, who are the tutors, and what will be the lectures, how will the lectures be conducted, what will be the format of the exercises, and how are you going to communicate with me, and how am I going to communicate with you for lectures, for everything. Okay, so let's go. So this is the summer semester 2020, and I'm going to give you an introduction to our team. I'm going to introduce you to the team. The first person is me. My name is Ronak Kosti. I have done my PhD in computer vision, specifically recognizing emotions, and I have been working in machine learning computer vision field since the past at least 10 years now, and I have also at pattern recognition lab. I am working in digital humanities field. I will be the one who will be taking majority of the lectures, and I will be the point of contact for you for the lectures. Let's see who else is in the team. Vincent Kristelein is also part of pattern recognition lab, and he's working specifically with computer vision, writer identification, and document processing and analysis. There is a lot of historical documents out there, and which are unprocessed, and it is really important to know who is the writer and how to identify what is written in the document also, and Vincent has been working in this field. He also has a background in pattern recognition, vision. If you have seen him in Project Computer Vision, then you would already know him. The third person who is going to take our, who will help us out in as much capacity as he can, is Mark Steiminger, as you already know, and if not, he has been taking computer vision since the past few years along with Christian Rees. Unfortunately, this year, because Christian Rees has some, he is going to take some holidays, so therefore he was not able to give the lectures for computer vision, and this is where I stepped in. Another Mark specifically works with reconstruction of images in the graphics department. He's the head of the graphics department. He's specifically working with incomplete data and reconstruction of that, and recording of surfaces, characteristics, and 3D objects. The next person is, I introduce you to our tutors, Prathamesh Madhu is also a PhD student, is a PhD student at the Pattern Recognition Lab. He is doing his PhD in the lines of digital humanities and computer vision in intersection of these two fields. He's the main, he along with another tutor are the main people who you have to contact for exercises. Prathamesh's background is in specifically in computer vision also, and in his master's he has done work in work with super resolution, and currently he is doing work with, as I said before, digital humanities, as well as in medical field he is working with some surgical procedures, images and videos of the surgical procedures. The next person is Darius. He is from graphics department like Mark Staminga. And he's working with computer vision and graphics and has been a tutor in the past for computer vision exercises also. He's also working with reconstruction and SLAM. SLAM is simultaneous localization and mapping. He's also working with reconstruction, augmented reality, virtual reality, and some optimization techniques. So this is our team for this semester. If you feel like you cannot, you have a doubt or anything, and you want to contact anyone, you are free to write emails to anyone. But I would prefer that you write emails with to the whole team, and preferably first you start writing your doubts and queries in the forums, so that we can look at it, anyone of us at any point, and reply to you as soon as possible. So what is the organization? How are we going to do the lectures and exercises and so on and so forth? Let's talk about lectures. We are going to adopt an inverted classroom approach. What is inverted classroom? Basically, like this video, we will pre-record lectures in smaller parts, maybe 15 minutes, 20 minutes, even half an hour, and share it with you in advance before the actual lecture starts. And you are expected to go through the lectures and watch them. And during the lecture time, during the official lecture time, which is Thursdays between 4:15 to 5:45, I will start a Zoom session. And anyone who has any doubt regarding any topic that has been uploaded in the recorded videos can join me in the Zoom link and ask questions directly to me. If nobody has any doubts on anything, I might have something to show extra, but I cannot guarantee that. The actual lecture period is mainly for doubt solving sessions, so please take advantage of that. If you I highly recommend you to watch the lectures before and come up with questions or queries or any random trivial stupidest questions you can ask, because that's how you will learn. So that keep in mind, watching the recorded videos before the actual lecture time and then joining it. I will try to upload the lectures 1 week in advance so that you have enough time to watch the lectures and videos, and then if you have any questions you can ask me during the actual lecture time at Zoom. Okay, how will I save the videos? So I thought of doing a lot of naming conventions for making it simpler to read, but basically I will write as L_1 will represent first lecture and underscore the parts of it, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, whatever, for example, as you can see in this slide. And you already know, as I am speaking in English, the language of this lecture will always be in English. Unfortunately, if you are not comfortable with it, I'm sorry that it will be very difficult for you, but I would still recommend to make an effort. Okay, next we talk about exercises. So in total we have five graded exercises and two non-graded exercises. The two non-graded exercises are related to the course, and the first one will be given starts this week, and it gives you an introduction on Python, OpenCV and NumPy, and also it gives you introduction about how to set up virtual environment to do all your exercises. This virtual environment is important because it will be once you set it up, you will be able to run all the exercises there, and you have to make sure that your submission code also is compilable in that virtual environment, without which you will not get any points. The second non-graded exercise will be given at the end of the course. It focuses on convolutional neural networks. Convolutional neural networks, CNNs as they are called, are state-of-the-art networks these days for many of the computer vision problems, and they have proven to be very effective in solving vision problems. And so we will take a look at them and see how they work, and I think it is important for you to know on the state of the art. It's a non-graded exercise, so you don't have to worry about it, but it's always good to know. Every exercise, the graded ones, will carry 20 points each. So there are in total you can get 100 points. You need 50 points to clear the exercise and be eligible for doing the oral exam or online exam as we say fit for the lectures. So you need to have minimum 50 points from the exercises. And you have to do all the exercises in groups of 2 or 3. If you are alone, you were not able to find someone, then please contact the tutors. They will help you and sort the situation out. You cannot have more than, we don't expect more than 3 people in a group and no less than 2 people. Okay. How will the exercise be graded? It is dependent on the tutors, how they see your code, if they think that it is incorrect or there is a plagiarism in your code, they will do a rigorous check of that and then maybe contact you to explain the code. And depending on what the tutors decide, whether to talk with you or they are happy with your submission, you will get your points accordingly. About the module, the module consists of the exercises and lectures. In a combination, they will fetch you 5 ECTS credits. Remember that for getting 5 ECTS, you need to clear exercises as well as the lectures. Because for qualifying for oral exams for the lecture, you need to clear the you need to have minimum 50 points from the exercises. And the final grade will be given 50% equal weight for the exercise as well as for the oral exam or the written exam, as we will decide later. So let's say if you get 90 points from your 100 points in exercises, then that will be converted to 45 points for the exercise proportion. And in the end, we talk about materials. So there are a lot of materials going to be, and there are already few of them already are regarding related to computer vision course, and they will all be hosted on students' computer vision location, as you can find it from the slide here. It will serve as a center point for everything. It is you can get your slides, the video lectures, the pre-recorded video lectures, the exercises, submission platform, discussion forums, and everything. So if you have anything, any doubt or anything related to computer vision course, you just go to Studon and you will find it there. And about the reference books, there are 2 important reference books which we are going to refer during the course of this lecture, as well as the whole syllabus. These 2 books cover quite a lot of topics. So after every lecture, when you see that there is a new topic being talked, I would recommend you to go back to the books, to the reference books, and read a bit more about it to get hang of the topic and have a clear understanding of it. And if you have any doubts, you come back to the Zoom meeting and you ask the questions. The first reference book is by Richard Sizlesky, Computer Vision Algorithms and Applications. There is a divided opinion. A lot of people like this book, some people don't like this book. My suggestion would be to go and read the book. It is freely available. If you don't like the language, you can always look up other resources on the internet as well as in our libraries. Yes, and second is Richard Hartley and Andrew Zimmerman, Multiview Geometry in Computer Vision. And this book mainly focuses on 3D and geometry topics. It's one of the best books out there, and I hope that you will like it and have fun with the book. So this brings us to the end of our first part of the first lecture. The next part, in the next part, we'll start talking about some of the objectives of computer vision and some state-of-the-art techniques in computer vision that we are going to see in the next part. Thank you.